Welcome back. We start the second quarter of play. Along with Renee Nato, I'm John Sanders. Glad to have you along with our ESPN regional crew here in Morgantown on a gorgeous day. The Broncos are getting set to punt from their own end zone. Back at about his own 45-yard line as Vaughn Rivers to receive the kick from Jim Laney. So this should be good field position for West Virginia. They have the lead as the second quarter is underway. A little bit of a line drive kick. He'll field it at the 48. Come right up the middle and be brought down near the 42-yard line. Tackle on the play by London Fryer. And yes, that is Irving Fryer. He was a starter last year, but is not starting so far this year. But Fryer made the tackle on the special teams. 45-yard punt, 11-yard return, and another flag on the field. I think that's to be expected maybe in these early games, you know?
Well, you know, it is, and it's a shame. You know, the thing is, Western Michigan at kickoff and special teams really is the number one special. But, you know, you're going to have these kind of plays like this.
5 yards on the kicking team. First down.
Opening game. There's no exhibition football in college football, so you're going to have things like this happen. But, you know, it's you don't mind a penalty that's over-aggressive or trying somebody's working hard, but carelessness or things like that, that's something
first
that could.
And they come out ready to go. Slayton, Sowers is in there, number 12. Reynaud, you've got four wideouts in this formation. Working out of the gun, and they didn't huddle when they came on the field. We never see him huddle except on the sidelines. That's about the only time. Now White looks over at his bench. And we have a shocking football score. We're going to report to you when we get a chance. White in trouble, and he's not going to get away. White is dropped on the play. McConnell made the play. He's going to lose just a yard. I think that play was kind of messed up from the start. It didn't look like it really had a, what they planned.
Well, what I think must have what happened here.
There, look at this. How about that? 26 seconds left. App State, which had a big lead, a two-touchdown lead, pulls out the winning field goal and knocks off number 5 Michigan. That is unbelievable.
Was that the Appalachian State homecoming game?
Well, they're not only going to get a big check, they're going to get a big win. Here's White. Spins away, and he's still on his feet at the 30. Tries to get outside and does. 20, pointing to his blockers. 10, 5, touchdown. What a run. Unbelievable. No flags, 38 yards.
Wow.
It looked like he was going to be tackled at the line of scrimmage.
And that's pure athleticism. You know, he tossed a couple of touchdown passes earlier, and now he does it with his feet. And he's the total package. John, and he's much stronger, again, as we said, than his program weight indicates, 185 pounds.
Pat McAfee again. Jeremy Cash, the holder. Third PAT is up and good. Now 21-6. The Mountaineers beginning to flex their muscles a little bit. Of course, they got good field position after the penalty on the punt return. But Pat White, 25th career rushing touchdown, and this is a beauty. Watch the moves. Gets away from two defenders there. Another deke, another move, and then he points for his blockers. Okay, you get this guy, I'll get this guy, and I'll score. And that a scintillating run by Mike White, who is quite a kid. He's a terrific athlete and a very good young man. And I tell you what, he did a wonderful job on that play. Kept it alive at the line of scrimmage. And for Rich Rodriguez and company, he was able to get downfield and make the touchdown. So another kickoff coming. West will be deep again. And you know, these West Virginia kids were anxious to play somebody other than a teammate, you know?
Yeah.
It's West again, this time at about the 6-yard line. He's at the 20. Across the 25 out to the 30. That'll be the starting field position. A 24-yard return. Sims made the tackle, and Lutz look again in an exciting athletic run by number 5.
He really improvises with this play just all over the field. And Rich Rodriguez has a saying, scratch where it itches. You know, he had a couple of touchdown tosses. Now he does it on the ground, and he just lets them loose, and the athleticism takes over. But you won't see many runs better than that. And let me just say this. You know, people have said this is subject to debate. But people, when Michael Vick came out of Virginia Tech, they said, oh, he'll never be a quarterback in the NFL. This kid can be a quarterback in the NFL. I know they're looking at him maybe as a wide receiver or running back, John, but he may have the skills, more skills than people thought.
And defensively, Lewis is out there despite the injury, and he is playing. Brandon West is the man in motion as Hiller goes out of the shotgun, and that's going to be a flag coming all the way from downfield. It'll be a delay of game call.
Alignment and defensive backs, and every week Pat White cleaned the locker room with the position regardless if it was his turn or not.
And there comes the flag for the movement, and right now the Broncos are out of sorts, but that is a great story.
Yeah, and you know something else he did, you know, that Steve Savarese used to play the guitar during Christmas time every Christmas season for
shotguns. It's 20 yards for the first down, and Hiller's looking for room. He'll go down at about the 22-yard line. Doug Slavik made the tackle, a 2-yard pickup. We are in Morgantown, West Virginia, Mountaineer Field, 60,000 on hand, all dressed in old gold and blue for the opening game. I'm John Sanders along with Renee Nadeau, and happy to have you with us as well. Total offense. West Virginia has been able to move the ball every time they've had it, a total of 221 yards. Rushing wise, that total is not as much as you would expect, because this is a team that averaged 300 yards a game on the ground last year. Second down, still long, passes complete at the Hiller looks, throws. That one is intercepted at the 40. The Mountaineers have picked it off. It was Lewis, number 6. We didn't even think he was going to play, and he comes up with an interception, a turnover. And that'll give the Mountaineers great field position at the 40 of the Broncos. And this is starting to unravel now for Western Michigan.
And Hiller is not a guy that throws a lot of interceptions. He only had 3 interceptions in 2005. But he's not setting his feet. That rush is getting to him. And I think he's a little confused by the defense that the Mountaineers are throwing at him right now. And Hiller is just not setting up. He has an ear, if you will, and listening the way that rush is coming from. And he's just not, feel comfortable in the pocket right now.
3 wide receiver formation. Slayton and White in the backfield. Smith at the tight end. Quick hitter ahead across the 35-yard line. Duclos made the tackle. He'll pick up 5 on the play. Duclos, a nice tackle there. It's second down. You can see the Mountaineers, they're ready to go anytime. Raynaud, Gonzalez, Jala, the wide receivers right now for West Virginia. And Schmidt is the tight end. He has only handled the ball once on one short carry. Here's a reverse. It's Raynaud. Slips down as he got inside the 35, maybe to the 33-yard line. There to cover him up was C.J. Wilson, a redshirt junior from Chicago. And just a yard on the play, and it'll be still third down.
You can't see it right here, but they're playing combo coverage. They're playing man up on one side and zone on the other. Good block by Pat White, and his feet, Raynaud's feet, just slide from underneath him. But they strung that play out pretty good, came up and filled, and kept him short of a first down territory.
Schmidt is the fullback. 4 wideouts in the formation. We have yet to see much of Jock Sanders or Noel Devon. And White is not going to get there. Ripped down as he tried to get inside. Cialinski. Cody Cialinski, number 68, made the tackle. And of course, you know the faithful want him to go for it.
You know, Cialinski, 6'2", 257. That's his program weight, so usually they fudge it a little bit. But he's an interior lineman playing against some big guys up front. So Cialinski is one of the better defensive linemen for the Broncos.
Steve Slayton moves out to wide receiver. Schmidt is still a tight end. A 4 receiver formation for the Mountaineers as they go for it on fourth down. Second time they've gone for it on fourth. And that one hit Jala basically right in the head.
Pat White's pass intended for 21.
Well, White just delivered that ball. It was a crossing pattern. One receiver went in. Jala came on a slant, and I think he was just not expecting the ball right there.
I think you're right. I don't think he was expecting it.
Quickly, White just three-step drop and delivers the ball, and Jala.
Boom.
He just didn't see it. Maybe came out of the sunlight. Who knows?
Well, it's the first time they've been stopped by the defense. Every time they were stopped, they turned it over. And the first incompletion for Pat White. He had thrown two touchdown passes in the ball game. Well, the Broncos will get it back at their own 33-yard line. Brandon West, the running back, smothered at the line of scrimmage. Not much there at all defensively. Morty Ivy, and what they'll do sometimes, they'll bring these backs up into tight positions along that line a lot.
Yeah, they will employ a, you know, they play a 3-3 stack, 3-3-5, but sometimes they'll bring Magro, a linebacker. They'll even bring a safety in. You know, they play with a free safety, a band, and a spur. And a spur safety is basically a monster back or outside linebacker, and they can move them around. Very, very good defensive scheme.
Filler on second down 10. Throws out into the flat. The pass is caught. Once again, it's Jamarco Simmons, the junior from Flint, Michigan. He is their number one receiver. He's going to get about four on the play. We're inside the 10-minute mark. Time left in the opening half. Mountaineers have scored on 3 of 5 possessions thus far. 2 touchdown passes for White and 1 touchdown run for Patrick. Third down, 6. West is the setback. Man in motion. Martin and Simmons are the wideouts. Hiller throws downfield. Pass is caught for a first. They're together right now. That's West with it. And he'll get to midfield and be ridden down on the play. Not much at all there. Maybe got inside the 50. Ball just inside the 50. Here comes the sweep to West. He's drilled as he gets to about the 46-yard line. And it's Mark Magro making the hit. Only a couple yards on the play. Broncos trying to get a drive going here at the midway point of the second quarter and see if they can get on the board. They use some razzle dazzle to get their only touchdown.
This West Virginia defense, John, runs pretty good. You see him sideline to sideline. It's tough to outrun them. Sometimes you know, what do you do? Get a reverse or you run against the grain, but it's tough to outrun them to the sideline.
This is a 5-receiver formation now for the Broncos. The preseason pick in the MAC. Hiller guns it. What a catch. West is the lone setback. Martin and Simmons are the wideouts. And did they take too much time again? Yes, they did. And that will not make the head coach happy. There. There's the quick handoff to the reverse man. That's Jamarco Simmons. And he is tackled for a loss. Malik made the tackle defensively. Loss of 3.
Good handoff. And
loss of 3.
It looked like it was developing, but Malik on the ground makes the stop. That's extra effort. Boy, I tell you, when you're on the ground and you make a tackle, that's really giving it everything you have. And Malik, just when you're on the ground, don't stay on the ground.
Past the midway point of the second quarter, it is second down and long. 18. Hiller hit the pitch. The ball is loose. Mountaineers are going to have it. Williams makes the recovery. A little late on making the pitch was Hiller to West. And Williams recovers. West Virginia gets their second turnover of the opening half and will have the football about 37 yards away.
That play was dead from the get-go. You see Hiller holding on to the ball, waits way too long to the ball, to the collapse on him, throws the ball, wasn't a very good pitch behind the runner, and West Virginia again with great field position, and Hiller just poor decision and a poor execution on that pitch.
First and 10, ball of 37.
So at the 37, the Mountaineers will have it, go out of the I formation. Schmidt is the fullback. Here's the pitch to Slayton. Trying to get to the corner. A flag down. Like maybe a face mask. Delmas made the tackle, but we'll check the call. 6:41 to play.
Personal foul. Face mask. Number 9 on the defense. 15-yard penalty.
15-yard, that's the major face mask on Delmas. So the brakes are not going the Broncos' way right now. There you see it. Wow. That's a face mask violation right there. Look at this.
I mean, he's, I guess, use everything you can to get him to the ground, but that's you're penalized for that. This is a third start in Western Michigan territory for the Mountaineers. Had a good field position, cutting the field in half for him. You know, but Delmas, good open field tackling in space. Talk about how good he is and what kind of prospects he may have for the future.
Schmidt back at tight end. Reynard. Gonzalez. Jala in there as the wide outs right now. As White works alone in the backfield. First down 10. Ball at the 22. Looking for the end zone. Yes. No. He couldn't hang on.
That White's pass.
Had him. Intended for Slayton. He got behind the defender that time, C.J. Wilson. But just could not quite hang on. Pretty good throw, though.
Nice touch throw, and Slayton comes out of the backfield. You see him in a slot, and he just goes on a go pattern in single coverage, and the defensive back just lost him. He didn't know where it was, C.J. Wilson, and Slayton should have had that. Usually he does, and
maybe
second down.
Slightly to the inside part of his shoulder as now Schmidt comes out. Sowers is on. They'll go with four wide outs. Slayton is in the backfield alongside White. Second down, 10. We're still in the second quarter in Morgantown, West Virginia, opening day. There's a bullet pass. That's going to be a first down at the 10-yard line. Darrell Jala made the catch. A 12-yard pickup and a first down for the Mountaineers. And he can gun it when he needs to, Renee.
He really does. And you know, he's got a good arm, good strong arm. And the thing is, he picked up the blitz once again. Here comes the blitz, and he sees the wide open interior. And Jala, who scored on a touchdown, a similar play, comes up with yet another grab and no huddle offense.
Now Schmidt back in there now at fullback. Three wide out formation. With Slayton the tailback. And there's the quick hitter upside to Schmidt. And he'll be stacked up after a gain of one by the middle part of that line. Dawson is in there. Duclos was in there as well. All kinds of defenders for Western Michigan as they try to hang on here in the closing moments of the second quarter. We're inside the 6-minute mark. And there's Schmidt. A guy that plays all over the place. He'll play tailback. He'll play fullback. They can split him out in the slot, play him at tight end. Right now they split the backs. And it's Slayton powering his way down to the goal line.
Steve Slayton on the carry.
C.J. Wilson made the saving tackle, a gain of 7.
Tackle by 59. Duclos.
Good handoff right here to Slayton, and following his shoulder pads.
Third
great
goal.
Left, good block on the left side. Stanchek and allows
ball.
Slayton to get close to the end zone.
It is third down and goal. Ball at the 1. Slayton, the only man in the backfield right now. And he'll get it, lean in, and score. Slayton, a 1-yard touchdown run, expands the lead to 27-6 as he scores the touchdown. His second.
Good surge of the offensive line. Look, they come up the ball very well and allow that crease where he can get into the end zone. Had a little contact by the goal line, but good momentum going forward. And Pat White, 92% in the red zone as a quarterback.
And that's perfect on the extra point. For McAfee is 4 of 4. The Mountaineers score their fourth touchdown, lead at 28-6 on opening day of college football. A gorgeous Saturday afternoon in Morgantown. Slayton needed a yard. He got the push from the big men up front and leans in. 28-6, West Virginia over Western Michigan. We'll be right back. As advertised, the Mountaineers begin to flex their offensive muscle in the person of White and Slayton here this afternoon. I'm John Sanders along with Rene Nado, and as advertised, that's pretty good offense.
They have hit you over the airwaves or on the ground. They've done it both ways, and even special teams have done a good job. But Pat White, boy, I tell you what, both Steve Slayton and Pat White have not hurt their Heisman hopeful chances here this evening.
And Rich Rodriguez is happy to see his team playing well. They did turn it over once on the fumble. Schneider Julian will be deep. He is the highly touted junior college player, and he's not been out there much today, but Snyder's going to be back. They call him Spider because they can't decide if his name is Julian Schneider or Schneider Julian, so they just call him Spider, and they're done with it.
Well, he's a 4-5 sprinter, so be careful. He's got his hands on the ball. He could take it to the house.
McAfee kicking off. And Spider's going to get a chance. Fields it at about the 9-yard line. Knocked down and lost the ball, but I think he might have gotten it back. A 19-yard return. Glover on the coverage there for West Virginia, and he momentarily lost the handle, but Julian gets it back. See if he stays in the game or leaves.
And you see Spider Julian putting a few juke moves on right here. And
yeah, he did lose it, didn't he?
He did, and lucky to get the ball. Lady Luck smiled on him. Ball bounced right back in his arms.
Football always bounces the wrong way, doesn't it? Didn't for him that time.
Depends whose perspective you're looking at, John.
Yeah. Outside the 25 at the 26, it'll be first down and 10. Keller alone in the backfield. No, he's not alone. It's Barnes who is back there now, a guy that had a good season last year. And Barnes is going to get his first carry. Still on his feet, fighting to get outside, and he will.
Did a good job.
And he's trying to get the first down, fighting up the middle. I don't think he's going to make
it.
No gain on that play. Maybe a half a yard or so, and that's about it. He was stacked up in the middle. That's Scooter Berry was there. Eric Wicks.
Stop by 93. Scooter Berry.
Berry with the tackle. The ball is still right at the 35, and it's third and maybe a half a yard to go.
They like Scooter Berry from North Babylon, New York. He's just a freshman. They think he's got a good future here in West Virginia.
Throwing on third down. Flag goes down. He did not make the first down. Williams made the hit. Rivers there as well, but I'm telling you, the flag in the background in the backfield.
Flag on the play.
Yep, that's what it was. In fact, it was the referee that threw the flag.
Yeah, you got to think Coach Cuban's got to be very upset with these penalties. A lot of them coming from the offensive line, maybe, and don't know if that one was, but. So Hiller trying to make something happen, and the hole was on the right side of your screen. We can't see it.
But you could see the referee, though, looking right at the play.
Holding.
He didn't make the first down anyway.
10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Remains third down.
So they will move them back on the holding call. It'll be third down and 11 with 3:46 to play. Nick Sad was called for the hold. Nick is a fullback who was in on that play.
This is what West Virginia likes. They can pin their ears back. It's third and long, and you know, they come and they know he's going to pass.
Four receivers. Bonds is the lone setback. Killer out of the gun. Looking right down the middle, throws it down the middle. It's caught. Did he make the catch? Ledbetter, the excellent tight end, is going to pick up a big first down on third and 11. He'll move it out to about the 44-yard line, a gain of 18 yards on the play. And Ledbetter, highly touted tight end, and he has done nothing to disappoint. He's also another guy from South Florida. He's from Fort Lauderdale.
Yeah, we talked about it. He had 9 grabs for 101 yards against Miami. He finds the open crease in the zone defense. Credit Hiller with throwing right between the defenders. But Ledbetter is definitely a receiving threat, more of a run, receiving quarterback tight end than a block.
Hiller is in trouble now, and down he goes. Magro and Lewis. Lewis coming up out of that defensive backfield to apply the pressure. They'll get him for a loss of 8.
And they come in a blitz. Hiller drops back before he knows it. West Virginia is all over him. Nowhere to go. He didn't know where they came from. Popped out of the ground.
Magro said, "You're not going anywhere." Look at that. 18 plays, 6 total yards, 2 turnovers in their last 4 drives. West is back in there as the setback. Hiller looks, throws, caught across midfield. Again, it's Ledbetter. He's going to be very close to a first down. Might have it. Depends on the spot. But Ledbetter, the big tight end, that's something that West Virginia doesn't really do very much. They don't throw to the tight end very much.
Well, you know, he had 37 grabs last year for 423 yards, and that was a tight end at Western Michigan a couple of years ago, Tony Scheffler, who was a second-round draft choice of the Denver Broncos. He had 57 grabs in his offense, so He's Brandon Ledbetter is very, very similar to Scheffler.
Flag before the play from the 45 gets underway. It is a first and 10 for the Broncos. And Rich not happy right now with his defense, specifically Lewis.
5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
It's a 5-yard penalty against the Broncos. Marched it back to midfield. Big statistical edge, obviously, for West Virginia in this football game. But the Broncos really have hurt themselves.
Yeah, you know, and the thing is, they've done some good things, John. Penalties have changed the way they approach. You know, when you're looking at a first and 15 and, you know, second and 15 or whatever, changes the way you look things. And they've moved the ball a little bit, but keep shooting themselves in the foot with penalties.
Filler completes the pass to Jamarco Simmons. He's got some room.
Knows how to get open.
Martin, Julian, and Simmons are the wideouts. That throw is short, and it is caught. West alongside. West turns into a blocker. That one is deflected. Scooter Berry, number 93, got a piece of that one. So with 1:26 to play, a 28-6 score. We'll turn to third down.
Juan Nunez was coming on a crossing pattern as a wide receiver for the Broncos, and that's what Hiller was looking for, and didn't get a chance to complete that pass.
Ball is at the 24-yard line.
And here's Hiller dropping back, trying to find a receiver wide open. He was looking for number 81, Nunez, and couldn't find his ball.
A good block applied that time by West. And now West slips the block, catches the short pass, and is going to be stopped at the 20-yard line. Play, trying to put something together, keep this drive alive, the throw, the catch. Yards caught already.
Might set a record here for himself, personal record.
It's first down at the 14-yard line. To the end zone. Almost picked off. It was in the hands of Reed Williams, and he could not hang on. And plenty of defenders back that time. They had like four of the blue shirts in the end zone and one receiver, and then the Mountaineers almost got their second interception.
That big gust of wind just now, John, was a collective from the Western Michigan sideline. He threw into five blue jerseys.
Wow.
And he's lucky he didn't come up with an interception.
Williams almost got that one, just over a minute to play. Straight ahead run by West, and he's going to
credit the offensive line for the success of this drive. They've done really, really stepped up and taken control of that line of scrimmage.
West. Don't know. Dingle made the tackle. Hiller throws. Incomplete, but there's pass. Let's see if they put it in the hands of West. No. Hiller. Looking. Still looking. Now running. And spinning in the end zone. Oh, Martin and Simmons are the wideouts. Ledbetter, the tight end. Looking, throwing. He made the catch. Back this year. Go to another bowl game. They hadn't been to a bowl game for 18 years until they went and played Cincinnati and Toronto. Bouncing kick is going to be fielded at the 20-yard line. And diving out of bounds on the return. So West Virginia will have decent field position, and they'll still have almost 13 seconds to do something with it.
Tackled by two, Brandon West.
With Patrick White and Steve Slayton as the primary weapons for the Mountaineers, you know, they're only the second quarterback running back tandem to exceed 200 yards per rushing in a single game. That's, you know, they both did it against Pittsburgh. White had 220 yards. Slayton 215 against the Panthers last year.
Three wideouts, actually four wideouts in this formation. One, maybe two plays coming up. We'll see if he tries to go downfield. Just 12 seconds remaining, and they go inside to Slayton, and he's going to be pushed back and dragged down by Vacatapain. Nick Vacatapain would not be moved out of there. He stayed right with him, and that's probably going to do it. And it is. They'll head to the locker rooms. That's the gun, and that's going to be the end of the first half. Well played first half. Mountaineers put four touchdowns on the board. But the Broncos have cut that lead to 14 now, as they were able to get on the board in the closing seconds. So they have certainly, despite all the mistakes, Renee, that they made, they have managed to stay in the ballgame.
Really have in that last drive. This is when you want to get it, a confidence booster, you know, going into the half. And I think Bill Cube is certainly going to come out of something good. And offensive line, really, give them credit. The game ball for the last drive did an outstanding job.
They certainly did. And they got over some mistakes that they made in the first half. But the Mountaineers going twice through the air, twice on the ground. White and Slayton have been a big part of it. They are celebrating a halftime lead in Morgantown. But the Broncos are trying to battle back. Our halftime activity begins. Our ESPN Plus halftime report, a closer look at Rich Rodriguez coming up after this.